Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel, Jennifer Marie, where I teach you different ways that you can make money online and become a work from home freelancer. If you are one of my subscribers, you know that many of my videos are related to Upwork, which is a freelancing platform where you can apply to thousands of jobs every day. And when you get a job offer, you will either get hired for a fixed price contract or an hourly contract. So a fixed price contract is pretty straightforward. Let's say you are doing video editing for a client and you and the client agree that you will edit their video for a fixed price of $200. That is the total amount you will receive once you complete the job. However, hourly contracts are a bit trickier. You will agree to an hourly rate that you will get paid per hour of work. And as a freelancer, you will log time with the Upwork desktop app, which will take automatic screenshots to ensure you are actually working. So let's say your rate was $60 per hour and it took you 4 hours to work on the video, then you would get paid $240 for the job. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to track your hours of work with the desktop app, adjust configurations, and how to revise and edit your work diary. I'll also explain to you how exactly you will get paid for hourly jobs. So before we get started, make sure to subscribe to my channel for more videos like this one on how to become a work from home freelancer. So first you need to install the app to your desktop, either on your Windows or your Mac computer. When you go to Upwork's website, just scroll to the bottom and click on Desktop App. Then select the version that you need for your device and proceed through the installation steps. The next step is to launch the app, and it should direct you to the most recent contract you're working on. If you are working on multiple hourly contracts at once, you can switch to the contract you want to start tracking by clicking on the arrow at the top. Then here you can scroll through or search for the contract you want to start working on and click on the contract to get started. Now, before you get started working, write the memo, which is just a quick description of what you are going to work on. And before you start tracking, make sure you are all set up on your computer ready to work. Then click on to start tracking the current session and the button should be toggled green. So now you can start working on whatever it is you are working on for your client. In my case, it was a voiceover, so I started recording on my microphone in Audacity. When you want to stop the session, maybe to take a break or whatever, just toggle the button again so it's grayed out. And to start tracking again, just toggle it on. Okay, so here you can see that I've tracked a half an hour while I was working. And as you are working, the app will automatically take screen captures at various intervals throughout. So make sure that this is working correctly, and you'll see the screen captures right here. To view all of them, click on View Work Diary. That will direct you to your work diary on Upwork. And here you can see the date or choose the date you want to view and the contract here. It will show you the total hours tracked. It will also give you an opportunity to add a memo if you forgot to earlier. This is important to make sure you qualify for payment protection and to let the client know what you were working on. Just click Add Memo if you still need to do that. You can see the screenshots taken while you were working, and they take a screenshot every 10 minutes. Now let's say you forgot to stop tracking and maybe went to check some emails or you went on Facebook and the screenshots showing aren't you actually doing the work you were supposed to do. You can click on the three dots beside the group and choose Remove Group, but you won't get paid for this session, so be careful to stop tracking when you're not working. Now, if you need to add manual time, or you did work that you did not track, you can click on Request Manual Time. Some clients allow this and others don't. If they don't, click on the Request button and then just write a message to the client explaining why you need to add manual time for work you did offline that you weren't able to track. Now I want to show you another way you can view your work diary and your timesheet. So go on Upwork, then click on My Jobs. Here you can see all your active contracts. The ones that are listed under active milestones and awaiting milestones are your fixed rate contracts. But we want to select hourly to view all our hourly rate contracts. Then click See Timesheet. So here we have time and earnings, and you can see the hours worked in the last 24 hours, this week, last week, and since you started the contract. So you can see I have worked 1.1 hours on this contract, and since my hourly rate is $125 an hour, I'll get paid $145.83 for this job.
We can also click on Work Diary and flip through to the date that you want to review. So you'll see the hours tracked in green and any hours added manually in yellow. So one of the biggest questions I get is, when do you get paid for hourly contracts? With fixed price contracts, you need to submit your work for payment or wait until the clients approve it. However, with hourly contracts, your clients are automatically invoiced and billed for the hours you log. So let's say you do work on week one and log time using the time tracker. Then on week two, your time is invoiced to your client on Monday, and they have until Friday to review it. And then you will get paid on week three. Your earnings will become available on the following Wednesday. So because today is Monday, I got a notification that the work week has ended and that my weekly summary is available for review. And when I click on that, you can see a summary of each day I worked on this contract last week, the total hours, and the payment anticipated. We can also click on Reports, and here you will see work in progress for any work that you are doing right now for your clients. And you can see under In Review, this is the payment I am waiting for the hourly job I did for this client. So later this money will go into pending, and then later when it isn't available, you can withdraw it. Finally, I want to show you how you can adjust settings on the time tracker. So when I was recording, I kept getting sound notifications of when the tracker was taking a screenshot. And since I am recording my voice, that was messing up my takes. So to make adjustments, click on the gear icon at the bottom of the app. Then go to Settings. And here you can change what monitor you want to screen capture. You can also turn desktop notifications on or off if you don't want to receive any notification when the app takes a screen capture. They can be a little distracting, so it might help you to have them off. And you can change the notification type if you want it to be simple or detailed. And then you can turn off the notification sound or even change it to your own sound. There are a few other settings you can adjust, like allowing the app to take a picture of you with your webcam too if you want, but you do not need to enable this if you don't want to. Okay, so that is it for my tutorial on how to use the time tracker on Upwork. Again, I normally work with fixed price contracts, I just prefer them, but I wanted to do an hourly contract video for you guys so you can see exactly how you track your work if your client hires you for this type of job. Thanks again for watching. Make sure to click like if you enjoyed this video and subscribe to my channel for more videos like this one on how to become a work from home freelancer.